Hey everybody, it's Queen of Light 1111. I hope you guys are doing well. I know I haven't posted here on YouTube in about a week. I've been very active on Instagram though, so if you're not following me on Instagram, I've been doing daily readings there. And my handle there is Queen of Light 1111. I have over 14,000 subscribers, so make sure that you follow that page because there are a lot of scammers out there that are trying to duplicate other pages, other readers, other accounts, and really trying to scam. So please be aware anytime you use social media. So today we're doing, you know, the typical Monday reading. We're looking at what is going on in the 5D for divine feminine, masculine, and the connection, and how is that energy grounding into the 3D. So if you want to book your own personal reading, coaching session, or healing session with me, go to queenoflight1111.com. So what's going on in the 5D? Look at this. Two of Cups, Five of Wands, and the Bridge. So, you know, spiritually speaking, in the astral plane, remember, in the 5D, you're always in union. Always in union, right? Union, separation rather, is an energy that is very much only a 3D concept, okay? You're always in union with your masculine. The masculine is within you. You have both inner masculine and feminine energies. When you realize that and you realize that your sacred partner, your outer twin, right, masculine or feminine, is already a part of you, you will not be in this desire and energy of lack and, you know, attachment. You're already going to know that you are in union. So in the 5D, there's this energy of the Two of Cups. The Two of Cups is all about union. The Two of Cups is all about, you know, these lovers, these twins that have this profound, deep love for each other. This is about love. This is about union. This is about harmony. It's clarified, though, by the Five of Wands. But what's interesting is in this deck, the Five of Wands is all about, look at all this conflict is around her. But within her, she is really holding this peace lily. She's really kind of trying to hold on to her peace despite all of what is going on. Five of Wands is about change and conflict and struggle. And so when that clarifies this Two of Chalices, this is telling me that the union was undergoing a lot of change, a lot of conflict, but guess what? We are overcoming these barriers. We are overcoming these issues, these battles, and communication is about to come. And there's going to be a compromise, okay? So that is the bottom of the deck. So let's talk about how this now specifically is for the divine feminine. What is her overall energy in the 5D as related to divine masculine? So in the 5D, she just continues to release. She continues to enlighten. She continues not to take action. She's in this energy of really focusing on her healing, focusing on her enlightenment, focusing on her connection to the divine. See, this is in a pendulum. She's in a pendulum. She's not swinging one way or another, taking action. She's just resting peacefully, connected to the divine, the Star card, and really focused on her individual healing, her individual cleansing. And I say individual because it's clarified by the island, because there is this time where she realizes, yes, we are in 3D separation, but in the 5D, I have already done all I can. All I can continue to do is heal myself. All I can continue to do is release my wounds, release things, release attachments, anything that doesn't serve me. And I'm doing this on my own at this time. Divine masculine's energy towards divine feminine in the 5D, 10 of Swords with the Sun card. He has experienced, he's been going through it with his higher self. I'll tell you that right now. So in his 5D energy, he has really had to go through a lot of different endings. His higher self has been working with him to really complete a major cycle so that he can rebirth himself into this yang energy, into this sun energy to create movement forward. So in the 5D, divine masculine is very much in this energy of ending anything that doesn't serve him, ending cycles, ending karmic cycles, ending karmic patterns. He's in the energy of just really trying to look at his own reflection, surrender, okay? And then complete this last energy so he can come into this with a fresh perspective towards success, towards victory, and move forward. So he is very much working with his 3D self to end cycles for this rebirth of the masculine so that he can create action and movement forward. And if you guys aren't following me on Instagram, I did a post today about Shiva and Shakti. Shiva is the male energy, right? In Hinduism, it's all about consciousness. Shakti is the power, the activating energy. Without Shiva, there's no Shakti. Without Shakti, there is no Shiva. When they are in their divine energy, where they have consciousness, the feminine is the energetic leader. When she leads energetically, it creates action. It activates the action in the masculine to take action. And what do we have right here? See, this is her energy. She's activating energy as divine feminine. And what happens as a result of that? He takes action. He takes action. His distorted self ends. He rebirths into the divine energy and takes action. So please, read my post on Instagram about Shiva and Shakti. So what is happening in the connection in the 5D? And I always say to spirit, if I get any pentacles energy in the 5D, I know that this is what is grounding. And look at this. This is about them working individually on their own in the 5D at this time. She's working on activating the energy, hence supporting masculine's activation to take action and move things forward. But in the connection, there is this mastery of both of them to move forward in love towards union. It's grounding. I'm telling you, I feel like this union is starting to ground. So much work has been done in the 5D plane, in the 3D plane during the last few months, that now we are in this energy of just processing, gelling this all for this grounding to occur in the 3D. So how are these energies now translating into the 3D? Look at her, divine feminine, six of cups, and the moose. There is this energy the divine feminine definitely has around wanting reunion, but she is protecting herself. She is standing in her power. She's being very independent at this time. And so what does that mean for divine feminine in the 3D? So we know that she's not taking any action in the 5D. She continues to activate her energy, which then of course goes to her twin. How is this activation of this energy coming into play in the 3D? Eight of Cups. She's walking away towards any sort of chasing of union. She's walking away with unconditional love. She's like, you know what? If this works out, great. If it doesn't, I trust the divine. She's the magician. She has mastery over her emotions. She has mastery over anything that has weighed her down because she has done a lot of soul searching in order to stabilize herself. And this energy of holding on to, her lessons and this energy of, you know, no movement in the connection, she actually sees this as a blessing in disguise, that there's no movement right now because it's not time. So I am surrendering this hold and this attachment to, why isn't he coming? Why isn't he calling? Why aren't we talking? Why aren't we in union? She's releasing all of that. She's very aligned in the 5D and in the 3D. Okay, the magician and the hermit are both solo cards. And then here in her 5D energy, she has the solo card as well, the island card. So it's very much telling me she is in union of self. She's absolutely aligned with her higher self here in that she's walking away from chasing anything, chasing her masculine, chasing union. She's mastered her emotions. She has stabilized herself in her soul search. And she understands that no movement is actually a good thing right now. Stillness is actually a good thing right now. Divine Masculine's bottom of the deck. How is this energy grounding for him? Well, look at this. He knows she is his queen. He knows she is his empress. And he knows he wants to get things going again. He knows that he wants to move forward to her again. So now, how is this grounding in the 3D? You can't make this up. Two of Cups. Bottom of the deck, Two of Cups for the 5D energy. Union is grounding. So for divine masculine, this end where his higher self has really intervened here for him, because of this detachment of divine feminine, it has allowed spirit guides, angels, higher selves to really work with masculine. And how is this grounding in the 3D for him? Two of Cups. There's this union that he wants to move towards. He wants communication. He sees these small offers that he used to make were from a place of pride and ego. And now he's healing and harmonizing. Okay, he's wanting to come back together and date divine feminine again, who he sees as his Queen of Cups. And thank God this card flew out. It tells me that the Queen of Cups is divine feminine, who is this intuitive, who is in her heart space, who is in her compassion, who is in her emotional mastery. He knows he has to put in the work, and he knows that he has to clean up the mess that was created with her and within this connection. So now, how is the union grounding? How is the 5D connection grounding? You can't make this up. Emperor, divine masculine in his power, matched to the Empress, which is at the bottom of his deck. He's honing his thoughts. He's getting these flashes of insight. He's in this energy where he sees the potential of this specific connection. So how is this mastery, movement towards love and union, now grounding in the 3D? Both are in their personal power. They are lifting out of negativity. These third-party situations from the past are now being healed. People are now moving out of any karmic connections or any karmic cycles, because there is recognition of this divine feminine. There is mastery of emotions. And now they have these enhanced visions and awareness that this is the union that they want to bring in to this world. You cannot make this up. Oh my God. If you want to book your own personal reading, coaching session, or healing session with me, go to queenoflight1111.com. And one last announcement. I am actually selling these beautiful, beautiful pendants with a one card reading. I'm going to show you right now. Oh my God, look how gorgeous these are. Look at this. These are blue, midnight blue druzy crystals that are, they're raw in the back. They're all natural. And I'm selling these with a one card journey of love oracle reading that tells you where you are in your journey of love. They're only, I think we only have 10 of these, and we've already sold some. And so the one that you choose on the website will be the specific one that you will get. And so if you want to purchase your own pendant with that one card reading about where you are on your own journey of love, go to queenoflight1111.com. Look at how beautiful. Look at how beautiful. Anyway, I hope to see you guys soon again with another reading. Have a great day. Bye.